Ladies and gentlemen, it's a great pleasure in a few slides to take you through the context in which we operate in the WHO European region and particularly on the vision of the World Health Organization on integrated people-centered health systems. I was mentioning the Alma-Ata Declaration in 1978, which is still very relevant. But of course, the context in which we operate, including the health system in Europe, has drastically changed. We see mainly demographic changes, meaning the aging of the population, which brings with it chronic diseases, multimorbidity, but also we see epidemiological changes. The disease burden has changed from a predominance of infectious diseases to a disease burden in Europe, about 80%, which is due to chronic diseases. On top, we also have a lot of technological changes. Now, some people say these changes have always been there, but maybe what is especially different is the pace of change that we are seeing. In addition, we know that the population is requesting and expecting a lot from us, the health community. Fortunately, it's not all challenges. If we look throughout the region, we note a lot of innovations, including, as we heard from Dr. Tsoi, also in Kazakhstan. We see new models of care throughout the region. We see new competencies of the workforce. There are many models of primary health care where we see that solo practices of general practitioners have been replaced by teamwork, by multi-profile teams, where the focus is not only on the disease, but shifting from a focus of disease to a focus towards health, which means that also in the university, we have to put a lot of attention not only to the healthcare, but to public health, health promotion, disease prevention. At best, tomorrow the doctor can cure the disease, but it is today that we ourselves are producing and co-producing our health. Next slide, please. In developing the vision for people-centered integrated care, the WHO paid a lot of attention to what we call policy alignment. It means that the vision is built on the principles and the values of previous normative documents and initiatives. Of course, the vision of integrated people-centeredness takes into account the Alma-Ata Declaration on Primary Healthcare, but also the Ljubljana Charter on Healthcare Reform in 1996 in Ljubljana, Slovenia, the Tallinn Charter on Health Systems for Better Health and Wealth in 2008, the European Health Policy Health 2020, and of course now there is a completely new context with the Sustainable Development Goals, the so-called 2030 Agenda. Not so long ago, the heads of states committed to implementing or moving towards the Sustainable Development Goals. This is a fantastic opportunity for us, the health community, because health is seen as central to development. And because the fact that the heads of state committed to the Sustainable Development Goals, we can hold them also accountable to prioritizing health. And finally, we took into account the global framework on people-centered integrated care, which was adopted at the World Health Assembly this year. Next slide, please. In 2015, we presented to the Regional Committee the priorities in health system strengthening for the next 5 years in the WHO European region. The document is available on the web. This is a summary in one slide. The 53 ministers of health committed to the following priorities for the next 5 years. The first one is transforming health service delivery around primary healthcare. It means to transform the health services from a fragmented system where the different levels of care are operating mainly independent and focused on treating the disease in different episodes in one's life, moving towards a service delivery which is providing continuous and comprehensive care throughout the life course approach, with putting a lot of attention to public health, to keeping healthy. And this is centered around primary and community care. It is in this context that the Office, the European Centre of Primary Healthcare, has such an important role. The second priority is moving towards universal health coverage with the ambitious aim of a Europe free of impoverishing health expenditures. So, two priorities. In order to translate those two priorities at the country level, three enablers, three foundations were identified. The first one is enhancing the health workforce, working towards a sustainable workforce. We are now in the process of developing the European Action Plan on Sustainable Workforce, which we will present to the Region Committee in September next year. The second enabler is ensuring access to affordable and quality medicines and health technologies. We are also preparing a document for the Regional Committee next year to the 53 Ministers of Health on a proposal for collaboration between countries to ensure access to the population on affordable quality medicines and technologies. This is becoming the number one headache for the Ministers of Health, both in the western and the eastern part of the region, particularly the new high-cost medicines, like, for example, the drugs to treat hepatitis C, but also new generation of diabetes and cancer drugs. In Germany, from 2013 till 2014, the expenditure on drugs rose with 10%, with 2 billion euro more, and we see this phenomenon in most of the countries. The third enabler, which you see vertical on the slide, is boosting health information. And this whole vision, all the priorities, are underpinned by what we call managing change and innovation. How do we as a health community lead and manage change? And this is also what the ministers of health are asking WHO more and more. Ministers are telling us, we know what to do and why, but we need WHO to help us more on the question of the how. Despite of all the challenges, how do you move to a health system transformation? With this in mind, we are going to focus today on the first priority, which is on transforming health service delivery. At the regional committee recently, meaning this year, the 53 member states adopted the European Framework for Action on Integrated Health Service Delivery. So this is a commitment from the 53 countries. The European framework is modeled around what we call four domains, three core domains and one cross-cutting domain. And you see them here on the slide. The first domain is the domain of the people. If we want to have people-centered health systems, we have to start from the needs of the people, not only the health needs, but also the social needs, the determinants of health, and to empower the population and engage the patients. The second core domain is services. And you see under each domain different areas for action. So the service domain deals with the features of the service delivery which need to be improved in order to transform your service delivery. The third core domain is the health system. And this operates at a unique interface between the service delivery and the other health system functions. In order to have a sustainable transformation of the service delivery, we need to pay a lot of attention to the other health system functions, For example, once you define your new model of care, then the financial incentives have to be aligned. Then we need to work on new competencies for the workforce. It needs to be underpinned by innovative health technologies like the electronic patient medical record, e-health, m-health, etc. And those three domains are underpinned by what you see on the slide. Change is Minenia, the change management. Because what we see in Europe is so many pilot projects on integrated care. But once that the donor withdraws, most of those pilot projects are dying out because they have not been designed through a very participatory approach and taking a system perspective into account. And that's why the change management component is so important. First of all, to get all the stakeholders around the table, but then also to roll out your pilot project.